the oceans of the world were the home of Big Blue. He was the greatest monster that the world ever knew, and the place that he loved best was the waters to the west. Around the blue Pacific he did roam. Big Blue moved alone, for a mighty blue was he. And the battles of the whales was an awesome sight to see. And he took them one by one, and he drove them all away. In the mating of the day he was king. Big Blue had 50 wives, and he sired 40 sons. The most of them fell victim to the cruel harpoon guns, and he was too much wise to get caught by the gunner's eyes. So he lived at the sea 100 years. His mouth was as large as a tunnel, so they say. His hide was as thick as leather, his eyes quick and small, and his back was all scarred by the times he got away. And he knew the smell of whalers, did Big Blue. Big Blue passed away to his natural decay. Beside the Arctic Circle he traveled up that way, and there never was a man who was born with a gunner's hand, who ever took a pan to Big Blue. Now the gray whale has run, and the sperm is almost done. Finbacks and the Greenland rights have all passed and gone. They've been taken by the men for the money they could spend. Killing next ends, it just goes on. The oceans of the world were the home of Big Blue. He was the greatest monster that the world ever knew, and the place that he loved best was the waters to the west. Around the blue Pacific he did roam.